This video is going to show you how to install a software application using CrossOver's install technology without the usage of our CrossTie installers. And as many of you may know, many of our applications come with what is known as a CrossTie, which is basically a little recipe that tells our installer how to install a given piece of Windows software. So for instance, if we go to a database entry here in our center, you'll see many of our entries now have this big orange install via CrossTie button. And basically, if you click on that, you're off to the races and you don't have to think anymore. But what happens if you've got an application that doesn't have a CrossTie associated with it, or an application that might not even be in our database at all? What do you do in that case? Well, this is what you do. I'm going to go ahead and take a look at another application here in our database called Fund Manager that I happen to know runs pretty well. As you can see here, it's got a silver medal, but it does not have a CrossTie associated with it. And this can be a good example for what you would do for any piece of unsupported software, how you would get it to run using our CrossOver installer. So the first thing that I'm going to do in this case is just go ahead and fire up CrossOver. And once CrossOver is running, I will go ahead up to the configure menu here and say install software. And that will launch our software installer. I'm going to tell that installer, hey, I'm not running a supported application here. I'm going to do an unsupported application. And not surprisingly, CrossOver says, I have no idea what you're going to be doing. So that's as we would expect. I will then select an installer to use, and I've gone ahead and just downloaded Fund Manager's install.exe file off of their website and put it on my desktop. And I will tell CrossOver this is the installer I want you to use. The next thing I'll tell it is what bottle to put it into. We have various flavors of bottles that one can use that have slightly tweaked variables, to emulate different versions of Windows. The stock version that we always suggest people try first is Windows XP. But you can also play games around using a Win98 bottle, a Win2K bottle, a Vista bottle, to see if that makes any difference. In some cases it will. You can give this bottle a name, and I'm going to go ahead and just call mine Fund Manager. And that's really all I need to do. Just point it at an installer and tell it what flavor of bottle to use. And at this point, as you can see down here, the installer says, hey, I'm ready to go. So let's go ahead and do this. And we will shortly be presented with the end user license for this particular piece of software, which is normal, of course. Most software does come with a EULA of some sort. Let's go ahead and say I agree. And it's going to ask, okay, where do you want to put the software? We'll put it in the default location of program files. And it downloads all the files it needs. I'm not going to run the tutorial, but I am going to run Fund Manager here. Many applications will have some sort of a little starter wizard that you need to fill out before the application is actually complete. So I'm going to go ahead and tell Fund Manager, hey, I'm going to do this later. And having done that, now I will quit Fund Manager, and that will actually complete the installation for us. And one of the things that CrossOver does is it also creates a set of launcher icons for us in our applications folder. So I'm going to go ahead and say done. And now I'll fire up Fund Manager here again using that launcher icon. And here we are again in our little startup wizard. So I'll go ahead and this time I'll actually fill that out. Give it a portfolio name, make me a ton of money, etc., etc., etc. Ba-boom. And there we have it, Fund Manager. And as you saw, it ran very cleanly, it installed very quickly. Your mileage may vary, of course, with other applications, but that's the general gist of what you need to do for any application. Point it at an installer, put it into a bottle type, and sit back and let CrossOver do its thing. Thanks very much, and if you have any questions, obviously feel free to get a hold of our technical support folks. They'd love to talk to you.